Hello everybody and welcome to this week's episode of the Spy Hunter Joke Expo. Today is the 40th episode of this season of Let's Play Junk Jack. So, because it's the 40th episode, what we are going to be doing today is a world tour because we haven't actually done one for this world yet, so I figured it would be a perfect time to do one. And since we're doing a world tour, I'm also going to have a new world download. And I'll talk about it a little bit more if you're having downloading issues and where you can watch a tutorial and etc. etc. So I guess. Oh, you know what? Before we start the tour, I found my first golem head. I got a sand golem head from Seth. And I got this because I was mining in Seth for some reason. I don't remember why. Why was I mining in Seth? I think I was trying to get more gold because we're kind of low on gold. Where's our gold? Right here. We only have 55. So we're kind of low on gold and I think that's what I was doing. I don't really know. I don't know why I thought there would be more gold in Seth. I don't think there is. I think I'd be better off in Alba or Zeno. But anyways, I killed a golem and I got a golem head. So for these, I think I'm going to put some shelves up here, up above our chests. And because I think there might only be 4 golem heads, at least right now. Or maybe there's more. There might be one per world? No, because there's not a golem per world. But anyways, enough jabbering. We're going to make ourselves 2 shelves real quick, and then we will get on to the world tour. Do I just want, like, a normal shelf? That's not a normal shelf. That's not a normal shelf either. Where are the normal shelves? Do I just want a normal shelf? I think... Let's just do a normal shelf. I think I'm just gonna do a normal shelf, guys. For that, we need 3 sticks, so we need 6 sticks because we're doing 2. And then, we also need some nails. Boom and boom. And woodworker's bench. Boom. Or not boom. There we go. Boom now. There we go. Let's just... Oh, but it gives us 2 each. Oops, we only We only had to make 1 set. Wow. Already my words are failing me. Okay, pop that up there. For some reason I was thinking that was gonna be lower down. I thought it was gonna be... Yeah, I might end up moving those somewhere else. I don't really know. It just looks so high up. But anyways, that is so we can always see our beautiful golem heads. So let's go ahead and throw these somewhere in here. I really need to figure out something with my chests because they are overflowing. This is kind of like my overflow chest. Half of this stuff should be in blocks. Some of this stuff should be in plants. And both of those chests are completely full. And I've also started putting animals that we collect in here. So I have a little bit more room in the... like the overflow / miscellaneous chest. So these are the animals that I have so far. And yeah, I'll be working on getting more of these soon, but let's start off this world tour. So here is our main base that we use. We pretty much just stay in here, really. Underground here. Oh yes, I should probably explain what this is based off. So this is based off the first level in the game called Fez. It's a super fun game. You should definitely try it out if you get a chance. I think you can get it on all the consoles. And then also it's like a in-store type game, and then also definitely on PC. But this is what it looks like all the way zoomed out. We got this weird little barrel thing. Over here we have our potions, and down here we have all of our miscellaneous things. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot about this island. We totally added on this island. This is our crop island where we just put whatever we need to grow, which I should really pay attention more to that and actually pick up crops and things. I think I did it once and then I just completely forgot about it. Down here is where we keep our bird independence. It is a guy, but I always forget that it's a guy. I think it's probably because he's pink, but yeah, I was for... Oh, is he sad? Are you sad, independence? Aw, independence is sad. I'm sorry, independence. I'm not gonna give you more seeds. I'm a cruel owner. I know. I'm sorry. Down here is our really... Oh, there are my shelves. Oh well. This is where I keep my buckets and stuff that I get from different like holiday themes, special chest things, my furnace room. Up here is where I cook things and keep my cooked things. And then up here is where I sleep, which we really need to redo our bed. We need to make a fancier bed, but we'll keep that for now. Over here is our Seth portal, and then up here is the rest of our portals. So let's start off in Seth and see what we have here. So Seth was just Seth was the first world where I went a little bit off the theme of Fizz. I've kind of kept with it for some of my other builds, except for the most recent one. So there really isn't much to show in here. This is supposed to be some sort of... this is not finished. There are some bridges missing. This is supposed to be some type of like oil or water tower or something. I think it's maybe more of a water tower. I'm not really sure because we got these things going here, and then on top is like a little water tower, and I'm realizing that you can't get up to it. I don't really know. I don't really spend much time in in Seth. So the next world that we worked on was Elba, and we actually, this was the first one that I did outside of the mainland. And and this is supposed to be a water tower. I'm not sure what level this was in Fizz. It was in a level though. And we have our lighthouse. Can you not? Good sir. Thank you. Oh, thank you for the essence. What are you? Water essence? Yes, water essence. This over here is useless. I think I actually... Oh, the top, that's not finished. I actually made this in an episode, I think, but then something happened to the file or something happened and the episode just, like, you guys never saw this get built. It's pretty pointless though, and obviously it never got finished. There's no grass on the roof, and you can see the bottom is kind of floating on top of the water instead of being like a weird island thing in the water. And then that is really it. You can see we've done some mining in here, mostly just to get Xeno portal pieces. And that's really it to show. I don't think... Is there anything further out over here? I don't think there is. Nope. The plans with this was to kind of build it out a little bit wider and just kind of have stuff on the water. But I just haven't worked on it. I think I want to maybe come back and work on this, finish up this build, make it so that this is actually an island. Because I like this place. I like the feel of it and stuff. Maybe we can make little houses or something. I don't really know. Ooh, I like the feel of it though. Next is Yuka. Yuka's pretty cool over here. This in Yuka, I definitely went away from the Fez theme with this one and kind of went back to my roots and kind of went back to my medieval, because medieval has always kind of been the thing that I've kind of stuck with in Junk Jack, just because it's so easy with the blocks. But here is the building that we hold all of our achievements things in. So in the description, I have a list of achievements that we are trying to achieve, and, items that I make for said achievements is where I put here. So one of them is to make all the trinkets that are craftable. And so that is what we have so far here, except for this one over here. I got that from a mob and I just felt like putting that there. Also, this place isn't quite done either. There still needs to be one more pillar, and then there's supposed to be water down here, which I just haven't got to doing, which I will do eventually. Here, I think I'm either going to put food here, or I was also thinking about putting fish stuff here, because getting all fishing rods, lures, and fish is one thing, and I don't think this middle area would even be enough for that. And then over here is potions. Each square showcase is supposed to hold one page of potions, because each page is four potions. So we haven't done 1, 2, or 3, but we've done 4, 3 off of 5, and then also page 6. So this would be 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and so on. Probably not, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. Because I think there's like 20, how many pages are there? There's 26 pages, so maybe that won't happen. I'm not really sure. But let's go back. I think the next two places we haven't actually built in yet. So let's go to Cryo. Cryo, we haven't built in. Is it nighttime? I think it's nighttime. Yes, it is. Cryo, I'll just show off this, what is it called? Surface. I kept wanting to say future, but that wasn't right. Surface mob trap. So we have this one in Yuka. And I think that's it. So basically what it is that there's just blocks up top that go every other one. So each block has surface sunlight touching it, which enables it to spawn mobs. And I have water streams all coming down right next to me. So that way if any mobs fall off or spawn near me, then they will all get pushed towards me. And then for the most part, they will actually die in the water because this is downward flowing water and they will eventually drown. But sometimes I will tap on them and they will die. And then I get all the goodies, all the good goodies. And this is the stuff that I have right now. I have taken quite a bit of this stuff out. We do actually need these. I'll just keep them in there because we really don't have room in our chest. Our mob drop chest is full. And then we just got Zeno last episode, I think. Yes, I think we just got it last episode. So we literally haven't done anything in here except for a mine that doesn't even go down to bedrock because we just got a vervain bean. So that was really all that we needed. And that's really it so far. I've definitely tried to go a lot slower with this season and just do stuff off camera or on camera and not off camera. So we really haven't made like tons of progress, but we have at the same time. And yeah, that is really it that we've done so far. I'm really tempted. Oh, vervain bean grew. Come to me. I think we might just make a luck potion because I really want to make a luck potion. But I'm considering breaking this and seeing if we can get 2 seeds. But at the same time, I'm really nervous that I won't get anything back from it. I'm just going to go for it. We only got 1 back. Dang it. Well, that's okay. I just want to try to get more going so we're a little bit more efficient with the vervain beans. Let's go ahead and put our nails back. And we can drop off this essence. So what we're gonna do now for the rest of the episode, since our world tour went pretty fast, we're going to make we can just get rid of these. We're gonna make some potions probably. I think, oh, you know what? I have a perfect idea of what we can do. So my dear friend Jesta told me that you can get rat tails in Terra, and I knew that I had seen rats somewhere, but I couldn't remember which world it was in. And it is in Terra, down near underground. It's just like deep underground. So, oh, is there a summer biome happy chest in here? I don't think there is. Nope, there's not. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna dig straight down. I'll probably cut, and then I'll probably end up kind of just, oh. Well, that's really sad. Okay, we need to make a new shovel. So I think, yeah, I'll just cut and we will get down to the bedrocks and just kind of like chill there, try to find some rats, and hopefully we can get a rat tail. I don't know if they're rare. I'm assuming they must be. I'm thinking if they're not, I may have just been like, oh, rat tail. Like, I don't need a rat tail. And then I just kind of threw them away when my inventory was full. But I'm gonna go ahead and get down to at least like prison biome level, and then we will do something. Alrighty, I have dug straight down and found myself a prison biome, and I have yet to actually see a rat yet, but hopefully we can run into one. I've also been picking up a little bit of gold as we go because of course we are a little bit low on it. Let's grab these keys. Awesome. I was out of copper keys. And I feel like we might not be that low down. I feel like this prison biome is actually rather high up. Because if you look, you can see there are multiple biomes below us. So let's just continue down, I guess, and see what we can find. Pick up this. Did we get a sapling? No, we didn't. Let's see here. I'm really just looking for a rat. I don't really care about you guys. I just want to see a rat. You are not a rat. Oh, we can open you. We got a bronze key. Get out of here. Bronze key. Sweet. I always love it when I find keys and then I find a chest that works with that key. And nothing useful. And then that happens. Let's see here. I'm just mostly seeing like skeletons and zombies. No rats though. I'm guessing maybe, oh, I'm stuck by a door. Maybe rats are a little bit closer to bedrock because we're really not that close. Ooh, we got 2 keys out of that. I'm really not that close to bedrock, I don't think. Let's grab this gold. I think I'm going to search around just a little bit more, see if I can find a rat. And if I can't, Then I'm gonna continue just mining down. Alrighty, well, I have been mining around for quite some time now, and I haven't been able to find a rat or a mouse or anything like that anywhere. It's really annoying. So what I'm gonna try to do, I don't remember if rats were hostile or not. Oh, there's another one of these guys. I don't remember if they were hostile or not. So what I'm gonna try and do, I'm gonna change my difficulty to peaceful. I know for sure when you go to peaceful, there are those like little tiny rats everywhere that don't do anything. But I don't remember if the large rats were hostile or weren't hostile either. So I'm just gonna look around here for a couple minutes. And if I can find a big rat, then I guess they aren't hostile. I just don't remember off the top of my head. Man, I remember seeing rats like everywhere at some point, but I've been all the way down to bedrock and there really was no caves around there. So I kind of came back up a little bit and you can see I've explored through here a little bit. But yeah, just not really finding any rats. It doesn't seem like they spawn when on peaceful, because usually when you go on peaceful, the mobs... Is there... Oh no, I thought that was a statue over there. When you go on to peaceful, the mobs that can spawn underground on peaceful are usually everywhere. Like in Yuka, I think it's frogs. Like there's frogs everywhere and it's really obnoxious. Let's see here. Let's search through here. I don't know if maybe there's a certain biome that you have to chill in. Or no, I guess it doesn't really go off biome. Like, animals or mobs don't really go off biome, so I don't know. I opened up a couple more chests, nothing really exciting whatsoever, just like ore and stuff like that. But let's see here, let's go back to very hard, because I am hardcore. And let's see if anything spawns in here, maybe? I don't really know, I don't know if it's a level thing or what. Oh, I forgot mobs spawn in there. Let's go down a little bit more. Maybe anything around here. Here's our meat flinger. I really just ran into like zombies and skeletons and that's really it. Yeah, I haven't really been able to find anything else. If I can't find anything, yeah, here's bedrock. I'm pretty positive that you find the rats in Terra, but maybe they're just like a bit of a rare drop. I'm thinking maybe I'll eventually just make a mob trap down here or figure out the level that they spawn at. Maybe I'm too high or too low. Maybe they spawn more around where mine shafts are. I really just want to find a rat, guys. Last week it was a vervain bean, this week it's a rat, because I really want a rat tail. Okay, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm gonna make a new world real quick and I'm gonna get down to a mine shaft biome around that level and we can see if there are any rats around there. I will be right back. Alrighty, well, I mined down and I found a mineshaft, so we are at the mineshaft level and still no luck with rats so far. I wonder if you can get rat tails from those guys. There are those, but I know that there are like big rats. But I don't know where to find those. I don't know if they're like somewhat of a rare mob, so you kind of just have to chill out for a while and hope to find one. Or if you can actually get rat tails from those smaller ones, like the one that I just killed. I'm pretty sure the one that I just killed, I think those ones are non-hostile, so they will spawn on peaceful. So... I just want a rat tail, but I can't find rats to get your tails nowhere, and it's really sad. Okay, so I think I'm just gonna give up on this. I'm just gonna give up on this, and I will figure out the rat tail situation later and just try to find one off camera or get one off camera. But for now, I think we're gonna go back and either make some potions or make some trinkets. I'm gonna figure out my inventory. And then I will get back to you. Alrighty, back in the mainland, and I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna make some trinkets. I was gonna make potions, but I don't think we made trinkets last episode, so let's go ahead and do that. I have gotten one more octopusy limb, but I still need one more. However, I got 3 crab claws, I think. Yeah, and you only need 2 for the trinket, so that is awesome. We're gonna make that one, and then also we're gonna make the green worm skin trinket, and what was the other one that I wanted to make? I think it was the ivory bone one, and I don't remember what the actual necklace part of those are. So this one needs printer silk yarn. We'll have to go grab that. This one needs normal yarn, and I'm assuming this one needs, oh, it actually needs normal yarn. I was thinking it needed primitive silk. I guess not. So here's primitive silk. That's perfect because we only need 2. And let's just go ahead and make these real quick, and then I think that is going to be it. Let's make the worm silk skid thick. There we go. Boom. And what does this one do? It's all right, I guess. It's all right. Most of the trinkets that you make are pretty dumb, I will be honest. Oh, we need a gold bar for this one. Oh, we need to make more gold bars. That's annoying. Okay, let's go get rid of you and make some more gold bars. I have almost 100 gold smelting right now, so that's going to be awesome to have. What am I making? I'm making the crab claw one. And let's just wing it. I don't feel like searching for it. I think it went like a diss. Tinkerer's tool bench. Boom. And what does this do? I haven't even looked. Gives you a little bit of thorns. Makes you a little bit faster. Those are really the only things that I would want it for. And the last one is, I just threw one of my yarns. The last one is the ivory bone trinket. And I don't actually know how you make this one. Like, I really don't know. yeah, no. We're gonna just need to find this one. And I think it is right here. Oh, I would have never gotten that. Okay. Like that. And I'm assuming this one probably gives you luck, which it does. It gives you 5 luck, which really is awful. And then the rest of those stats are pretty dumb. Okay, let's go. You definitely wouldn't make that. I mean, if you were looking for defense and attack, it definitely wouldn't use that trinket. And if you were looking for luck, you definitely shouldn't use that trinket either. Just use like a gold essence one or a gold or a, is it gold? No, it's not gold. It's something else. I don't really know. So put these in here real quick. And then I think that is really going to be it. Let's actually pick this one and bring it back. Because you are not one that you make. So you're not involved in the achievement. Let's put this stuff back real quick. So we only need 2 more trinkets now. And we will have filled up 3 showcases, which is awesome. I'm not exactly sure how many more of the essences we need to make. A lot of them is just kind of like the same thing repeated though. Like the essences and the gems. I think the hardest one is going to be like the gold peacock necklace. And probably these ones. All the carapace ones and the fin ones. Those ones are probably gonna be the most difficult. Worm skin ones, those might be a little bit difficult depending on which one they are, but the rest of them are pretty easy. I think you need to get these in, do you have to get these in Magmar? Maybe you don't. I don't remember. I think maybe you do. I don't really know. But most of them should be easy except for the ones that take forever to get the item. But yeah, I think that is going to be about it. I feel like I'm forgetting something. But yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching this week's episode of Let's Play JunkTrackX. Please like and subscribe and all that stuff. And shake you. Goodbye.